With me on the line this afternoon, I've got Paul Baay from Touchstone Exploration. Paul, good afternoon. Nice to speak to you.
Good afternoon, and happy to speak with you as well today.
A couple of updates out from you this week. Let's start with the production update yesterday, averaging more than 1,500 barrels a day in the first quarter. Paul, you're pretty pleased here?
Yeah, I think that's certainly the number that we had targeted. It's up just over 20% from Q1 of last year. And with current production being just under 1,800 barrels a day, you know, we're really starting to see the results of the wells we drilled last year now being optimized, as well as a couple of the wells from this year's drilling program just initially being on stream.
And this year's drilling program, the first five of those wells now successfully drilled?
Yeah, so we've got five of them drilled out of the 10, so two of them are on stream. One's been on for a little while. The other one's literally been on for a couple of days. So it's just way too early to talk about the production from that particular well. You know, as we want to just continue to take sort of 60 days of good solid production before we report them to the market, make sure these wells are leveled out before we'd anybody too excited about volumes.
But from what you've seen so far, you suspect these could have a decent impact on future production?
Yeah, I think our goal was to get the 10-well drilling program done for this year, and that would get us through the 2,000-barrel-a-day mark. I think there's a good shot that with the five wells that we've now got, we could certainly push through that 2,000-barrel-a-day mark. So to say we're a little bit ahead of schedule on the production side, I think would be a bit of an understatement at this point.
So as far as the program's concerned, just remind us, when are you looking to start on the sixth well?
So we drilled the five now, and we're going to drill wells six and seven from the same drilling pad. So we've got to make some modifications, make it a little bit larger pad. And so that's going to take a couple of weeks. So we'll be back in the field, we hope, in 2 or 3 weeks. But both from a production and environmental point of view, we're trying to go this route. It lowers some operating costs, and also it's better as many wells as we can drill off of one pad at a time.
And as far as the other update this week, the quarterly update, the numbers are pretty decent increase in revenue for the period, $7.4 million?
Yeah, so it's up significantly from first quarter of last year, which I think is probably the best comparable period, especially on a cash flow basis. We did about 400,000 Canadian cash flow last Q1 of last year, and this year we were just over 2.6 million. So what you're starting to see is the volume increase. Obviously, there's a price increase as well, but you know, if you take a look at the netbacks, they're over $30 a barrel now. Mm-hmm. So I think that all the changes we've made are really, really coming into effect now on the financial side as well.
And a bit of cash in the bank too, as you exited the quarter, just under $10 million?
We did, and you know, we did use a little bit of that to drill some of these wells, and you will see in Q2 and Q3 we'll grind through a little bit of that. However, with prices where they're at and being ahead in the production profile of what we were looking at, you know, this thing will start to generate significant cash to fund the capital program. So, yeah, overall, balance sheet looks strong, production looks strong, and certainly on the drilling front, the things are turning out as well or better than we hoped they would. So it's been a great 90 days so far.
A great 90 days, and the plan here, just keep going. Is that right?
Yeah, the 2,000 barrels that we keep throwing out is really just an initial target that we set for ourselves. But you're absolutely right, that is the initial target. I mean, we still want to get to 5,000 barrels a day. We think that that's a great number. Once you start generating that kind of revenue on the island, you can really take advantage of some of the bigger opportunities that we see there as well.
Paul, nice to catch up with you. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much for your time.